Tarohalava, thank you for having me on, and very good morning here from Wellington.
I can tell. Well, correct me if I'm wrong. I can tell it must be very cold in Wellington this morning.
It's a little bit windy, but it is sunny. So I'm hoping that once the sun comes out fully, that it'll be warmer. But I'm wearing my Māori Language Week, the Māori Language Commission jumper. You know, it's nice and cozy for a bit of work today.
All right, okay. Is there anything special about the Māori for this week or?
No, not this week. It's just a really great jumper, actually. I think we should do some for Samoa Language Week and Niue Language Week and Tonga Language Week. I think we
Right.
should have a jumper for every week. Then
Yeah.
I can have a new jumper every day.
Okay, fa tai lava lo fa tama tai min sta ba bro Edmonds mo le proclamation e foi tai fo caucus meeting at a labor il am tanga ne va ya so I'm sure there were a lot to talk about Monsieur la vol fil fil all detail so Chris Hipkins still the man.
Yeah, really good constructive meeting here on Tuesday in Upper Hutt for our Labour Caucus meeting. We endorse Chris Hipkins as our leader, and actually we have also endorsed Carmel Sepuluni as our deputy leader. So for those of you who may remember, Calvin Davis was our party deputy leader. The caucus unanimously endorsed Carmel Sepuluni. So she was the deputy prime minister, or still is the caretaker deputy prime minister, and now she is our deputy leader of our party. But yeah, lots to talk about, really constructive discussions around, the debrief about what happened in the election and how we stay focused and the plan going forward while we're in opposition.
Okay, well, talking about the election, did you manage to nail down some of the problems that you had, which result to Labour not coming back to government after the election on the 14th of October? Did you manage
Oh,
to
there's
do that?
definitely a lot of different reasons for it. And it really, the really interesting thing is it varies right across the country what was most important for different, for different areas. Like, for example, I mean, and this is very open and public, you look at Wellington. Wellington has gone very left. We lost 2 seats to the Greens and the rest to Labour. But then, oh, sorry, and then one is National Party, which is Chris Bishop. But then you look at Auckland, we lost a number of those seats and they went to National. So, obviously it's different in different parts of the country. But I think for our party now is to look forward to the future, to focus on us coming back in 2026.
Okay, Barbara, you didn't mention Carmel Cipollone, so still the deputy leader of the Labour Party. She's now in the Pacific. I think there's a Pacific Island Forum going on.
Yeah, there's the Pacific Island Forum, Leaders Forum that's happening at the moment in the Cook Islands. Carmel Sepuluni is the caretaker deputy prime minister, as well as Gerry Brownley. So he was the representative for the incoming government. They've both gone to this forum because it's so important to have, obviously a representative from both the incoming and the outgoing government. Because technically, Gerry Brownley cannot sit at the leaders' table because he is at the moment still an MP. Until he's sworn in, he is not. There is no government formed, and he's not a minister. But it's really good. It shows the bipartisanship, which is the, National Labour and across the House approach that we've always had when it comes to foreign affairs. So, and the Pacific Island Leaders Forum was a really important forum for us to have a representative from both. So Carmel is leading that delegation, and I think she coined the term Caramel Brownie for her and Gerry Brownlee's partnership that they have at the moment.
Okay, what do you think of the Electoral Commission errors and recount, Bob?
Yeah, so we definitely, there's always a review that happens through the Justice Committee, Select Committee. So that'll happen in obviously this next term coming up, in relation to some of the errors. The Electoral Commissioner himself has said that they're human errors. And when there's over millions and millions of votes to count in different processes, obviously it's important that that process is robust. I'm looking forward to being part of that Justice Committee, Select Committee. There has been a bit of commentary around concerns around the time that it's taken to do those special vote counting. But I think it's important to look back as to the principle as to why we've allowed people to enroll to vote on the day. So that is, I know that's been identified as an issue. But it means that there's no barrier for anyone to vote. Mm. You know, they can just turn up on the day and vote. And that didn't used to be the case back in 2018 and below, and beyond, earlier. So it's an important thing that we take our time, or, well, the government take its time to look at what that can be improved, but the Justice Select Committee will also run its review into the election.
Okay. Barbara, Olealo Silafia, and what do you think about Helen Clark's comment? Because I was reading earlier this week, well, Helen Clark, of course, former Prime Minister of New Zealand and former leader of the Labour Party. What she did say, Chris Hipkins' decision to rule out Peters for Labour coalition, there is some uncertainty in there. What do you think?
I haven't seen her comments, so I'm not too sure what they are, but going off what you've just advised around the uncertainty, it comes down to, if I go back to why Chris Hipkins made those comments. New Zealand First, one of their number one platforms, and it's still in their manifesto, is they wouldn't go with Labour. So, you know, they said that they won't go with Labour. And I think if you look at the supporters for New Zealand First, you can see why they won't go with Labour. But then if you look at why Chris Hipkins didn't choose to go with New Zealand First, it was very much because our values don't align anymore. You know, we worked with them. I worked under them under a coalition government in 2017. It was difficult, but, you know, we still managed to get things done, but it was difficult. And it's quite clear that the ideology of the New Zealand First Party has shifted quite considerably since then. Mm. And so that's why Chris Hipkins has ruled them out.
Okay, let's talk about I was reading earlier this week, under the caretaker government, people are experiencing stress as funds run out for first home partner program. Example, Ka Inga Ora. How much do you know about this, Barbara?
Yeah, so the I think that comes to, there was a lifting of the cap that we did to allow for multi-family, generational families to, you know, income cap so that they can apply for it. Mm. It's been quite a popular policy, and obviously they've basically run out of the funds to be able to distribute more of that, if that's what you've been sort of alluded to. That's something that the incoming government will need to consider, whether they increase that funding into it. But, you know, obviously Labour, it was our policy to increase it. And, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if we had had the chance. We would have increased the pooling, the funding for that. Mm. But again, now that's up to the incoming government as to where they put their priorities.
Mm. Okay, there were quite a lot of complaints. Well, use the word complain about one of the Green MP comments, Chloe Swarbrick. About a chant from the river to the sea. We all know what's happening between Israel and Palestine and the Palestinians. What's your thought about this? Do you think, as an MP of the government of New Zealand, should we stay neutral and be very careful of the comments that she made?
So Chloe isn't part of the government, even in the previous term. Like, we had a confidence and supply agreement, but technically the Greens are still opposition.
Yeah.
She's made those comments at a rally last weekend. She has apologised since, and I think that's quite sound, given that, you know, where that saying comes from is from, you know, obviously the Hamas element of it, which is, you know, part of Palestine. Mm. And everyone knows currently what's happening there. So she's apologized for it causing offense to some people. And I think that's a very sound decision, because right now, you know, New Zealand has been pushing through the UN for a humanitarian pause to what's happening in Gaza, between Palestine and Israel, and we will continue to work those different channels. But again, as the caretaker government, we are very much within the, you know, everything that we say in relation to this issue needs to be done with the approval of the incoming government, which is national.
Okay, Barbara, I'm finding it very hard to pronounce this word. Binicleus event in Porirua. Is that how you pronounce that word? Binicleus?
Oh, Binicleus.
Binicleus.
Yeah, Binicleus. So, is one of our most fantastic events, which is happening this weekend in Porirua between 11 and I think it's 3 p.m. at Te Rauparaha Arena. It was a, initially, it used to be a sort of a pink breakfast, big celebration for Pasifika women, a community health event. But actually, our Tamar group have come and joined together last year. So it's a really big health festival at the arena. Right. There'll be, you know, really good stuff for the kids to do, lots of health information, lots of entertainment as well. You know, we've had Gaseki, who is currently touring Australia. They will be back in time for this because we've got a really good relationship with those musicians there. It's just an amazing event, and it really is to bring our Pacific communities together so they can be informed about what's on offer for them in the health services. So come down, it's 11 o'clock tomorrow, and there's no entry fee to come in, but you can buy some crafts there as well if you want to.
What's the aim of the event, Bob?
Is to increase health awareness. So obviously before, back it was around breast cancer, you know, a pink breakfast, but now it's, you know, there'll be information around breast cancer, around keeping well as a for men, how they can do their health checks, for cancer, so all the different types of health issues, and basically bringing in all those different service providers from across the Wellington region to provide support.
Okay, my love, after telling love of your time, okay, before I let you go, you're traveling to the beautiful Tamaki Makaurau?
Yes, I am today. Yep, my son, who is year 13, has his graduation supper. So he has finished school. That's two out of six, two out of eight, so two down, six to go. So, you know, it's a really, you know, I think back to my dad when he came over from Samoa, he just wanted us to finish our education. And so, you know, that's provided an opportunity for our children to do really well as well. Yeah. So he's finished that. He's still got exams. He sat his scholarship exam for statistics yesterday. So I'm really proud of our boy. But, oh, man, you know, something about boys are really different from girls. You've got to really push them for the next bit. So really proud of our son. But it's been you know, we got a, you know, even though you've turned 18, you still got a lifetime of having to help them through it.
Okay, fafte tele lava la fiona tama time in star Barbara Edmonds more than a for tire four. Well, Maria lava de yaso, and have a safe weekend.
Thank you very much for time tele lava mole ava noa. Have a great weekend, everyone.
Fafte lava la fiona tama time in star Caretaker Government Barbara Edmonds and a for tire four. Smell of a fonga to one water to tell me some more ole ne for vai yaso.